السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Dear second secondary students, inshallah today we will start the first lesson in the calculus. I wish you can understand the lesson and it will be familiar to you because I know you are intelligent and smart students. Now we will start the first lesson. The first lesson in calculus is talking about the first derivative of the product of two functions. You know that, like we have learned in the first term, if you have y equal x power 3 plus 2x square minus 1, you can find y dash easily, like 3x square plus 4x. Huh? Let's remember how we found this answer. First of all, you have to multiply the coefficient here times the power and decrease the power by 1. It will be 3x square plus the same, multiply 2 by 2 by the power, 2 in the power. It will be 4x because you have to decrease the power by 1. And you remember that if you have a constant number like negative 1 has no derivative. So it will be 0, or the derivative 0, we didn't write 0. So y dash equal 3x square plus 4x. Note that y dash is the same as dy dx. Okay? Now we have to discuss our new topic, which is talking about the derivative of y if y is a product of two functions. Now, you can solve this question by the first method of the first term, but first you need to expand these brackets, like multiply this bracket by this bracket. But easily you can find the new rule to find y dash if y is a product of two functions. Let the first function called f of x and the second function g of x. Now the rule is y dash equals f dash x times g of x plus g dash of x times f of x. Remember that f dash of x is the derivative of the first function, like the first function here. This is f, so you have to find f dash, the derivative of the first function, times the second function without any changing, plus the derivative of the second function, which is this function, times the first function, which is this first function, without any changing. So the rule is y dash equal derivative of the first times the second plus derivative of the second times the first. Now let's see the first example. The first example is y equal x power 3 plus x power 2 times 3x square minus 5x. Now you can find y dash easily, derivative of the first function. Derivative of this function, which is the first one, it will be 3x square plus 2x. This is the first one. This is the derivative of the first one times the second one without any changing, plus derivative of the second one. The second one is 3x square minus 5x. To find the derivative, it will be 6x minus 5. This is the derivative of the second, times the first function without any changing. So this is the derivative of y, which is y dash. Remember that if you have the curve y equal f of x, and you have this point which is belong to the line, and also the point is belong to the curve, the point called x1, y1. Now y equal f of x, it's given as a function of x, and y dash also is another function of x. Like here, y is a function of x and y dash is another function of x. If L is a tangent at the point x1, y1, then f dash of x1 means you have to substitute by this point x1 in y dash. If you have substituted by x1 in y dash, then you find a number Okay, this number is the slope of the line L as the tangent. If L is a tangent, the number is the slope of this line. Okay, let's see the example. Let y equal x minus 3 times x squared plus 2. It's a function of x given as a product of two functions. Find the slope of the tangent to this curve at the point 1 and negative 6. 1 and negative 6. Now, first, if he asked you about the slope, you have to find y dash. So, y dash is the product of the first x minus 3. The product of it is x derivative 1, and negative 3 has no derivative, so 1, the derivative of the first, times the second as it is, without any changing, plus derivative of the second, derivative of x squared plus 2 equals 2x, because x squared has derivative 2x, and the 2 has no derivative, times the first one, the first is x minus 3, without any changing. Now, this is y dash as a function of x. To find the slope, you have to substitute this x in y dash by this x in the order pair. The x in the order pair equal 1. So, remove each x and put 1. It will be 1 times 1 power 2 equals 1 plus 2 plus 2 times x which is equal 1, it will be 2 times x minus 3 which is 1 minus 3 equals negative 2. Now you have to find the answer. 1 times 3 equals 3 minus 2 times negative 2 equals negative 4. The slope is negative 1. Then we find the slope. I want you to note that this example which we have solved, given the point, we have the point as a given. The point is given, and he asked us to find the slope. So, the given is the point, and the required is the slope. The next example will ask about the point and give us the slope. Okay, let's see. The next example, given the slope and required the point. Example, find the points which lie on the curve y equal x minus 3 times x squared plus 2, where the slope of the tangent at this point equals 11. So, we have the slope, and he asked us about the point, the opposite of the first example. First, we find y dash, derivative of the first. The first is x minus 3, has derivative what? 1, times x squared plus 2 without changing, plus derivative of the second, 2x. Times the first without changing. This is y dash. The slope equals 11. So, slope means y dash. So, y dash equals 11. We put y dash equals 11 to find the x. Now, x squared plus 2, this 1 times x squared plus 2. It's x squared plus 2 plus 2x multiplied by x minus 3. 2x times x equals 2x squared. 2x times negative 3 equals negative x. This expression equals 11. Now, x squared plus 2x squared, 3x squared minus 6 plus 2 minus 11 equals 0. 3x squared minus 6x minus 9 equals 0. Divide the equation by 3. X squared minus 2x minus 3 equals 0. So you can factorize into two brackets. X equals negative 1 or x equals 3. So we have two order pairs. This is the first number in the first point, and this is the first number in the second point. To find the other point, so you need to substitute by negative 1 in the equation of y, the equation of the curve, because this point belongs to the curve. Put negative 1 here in y, you get negative 1 minus 3 times negative 1 power 2 plus 2, it will be negative 12. And here, put x equals 3 in the equation of y also, so it will be half. It will be 3 minus 3, it will be 0, and 3 power 2 plus 2, so it will be 0. The second order pair, it will be 3 and 0. So we have two points, negative 1 and negative 12, and 3, 0. These two points are the points where the slope of the tangent at these points equals what? Equals 11. Okay? I want you to remember that the equation of any straight line equals y minus y1 plus m, y minus y1 equals m, times x minus x1. To find the equation, you substitute by x1 and y1 instead x1 and y1 instead of the point, and x and y without any changing, and m for the slope, m for the slope. So you can get the equation easily in the homework. Our homework is based on this lesson, lesson 1 in the calculus booklet. You have to solve lesson 1 in the calculus booklet, and I'll send you the model answer soon, inshallah, and I hope that you can understand this lesson. Goodbye, and see you soon, inshallah, in the next video. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.